myself Jalaja Sajeev, PGT Bio from KV Keshapuram. Welcome to today's session. We are continuing the genetics topic. In the previous section, we have already learned about dihybrid crows. Now, here is the question: a dihybrid crows is equal to the product of two monohybrid crows. For example, we are considering the characters tall red and dwarf white. We can divide this into two monohybrid crosses like this. First one, we will consider it as tall and dwarf, tall into dwarf, the first monohybrid cross. Second one, red into white, again the second monohybrid cross. As we all know that the phenotypic ratio of a monohybrid cross is 3:1, and the phenotypic ratio of a dihybrid cross is 9:3:3:1. Now, by considering this particular ratio 9:3:3:1, we can prove that it is a product of two monohybrid crows, that is 3:1:3:1. 3 into 3, you will get 9. 3:1, you will get 3. 1:3, again you will get 3, and 1:1, 1. So, the ratio 9:3:3:1, the phenotypic ratio of a dihybrid cross, is equivalent to the product of phenotypic ratio of two monohybrid crows, that is 3:1:3:1. Similarly, the genotypic ratio of a monohybrid cross is 1:2:2:1. And we know that the genotypic ratio of a dihybrid cross is 1:2:2:1, 2:4:2, 1:2:2:1. At the center you can see 2:4:2, and on either side you can see 1:2:2:1. Now, this particular ratio, that is the genotypic F2 genotypic ratio of a dihybrid cross, is also the product of genotypic ratio of two monohybrid crows. And we know that the genotypic ratio of a monohybrid cross is 1:2:2:1. So, it is 1:2:2:1 into 1:2:2:1. Here you will get the product 1:2:2:1, 2:4:2, 1:2:2:1. So, this can also be shown like this: tall red into dwarf white. It is a typical dihybrid cross. Now, here we will divide it into two monohybrid crosses, tall into dwarf The second one is red into white. So, consider the first case, tall into dwarf, the monohybrid cross. Here the phenotypic ratio is 3:1, that means 3 tall and 1 dwarf. Now, the second cross is red into white, write like this, 3 red into 3 red is to 1 white. Same thing we will write here also, 3 red and 1 white. Now, you can write like this, 3 into 3 9 tall red, 3 into 1 3 tall white, 1 into 3 3 dwarf red, 1 into 1 1 dwarf white. So, this is the way you can symbolize, you can summarize. So, 9:3:3:1, the F2 phenotypic ratio, it is the product of the phenotypic ratio of 2 monohybrid cross, 3:1:3:1. Now, like this we can write the genotypic ratio also. In the first cross we will get the genotypic ratio 1:2:1, where 1 individual is 1 capital T genotype, 2 capital T and small t genotype, and 1 small t genotype. Now, for the second cross you write like this, 1 capital R two capital R small r and 1 small r small r. This is also like this, 1 capital R you have to write, 2 individuals heterozygous capital R small r and 1 recessive small r small r. Repeat the same pattern and write in the same way, 1 capital R and 2 capital R small r, again 1 small r small r. Now, you can write the genotypic ratio like this and the combinations also you can write, 1:1:1 capital T capital R capital R, that means 1 individual is totally homozygous for both of the pairs of genes, 1:2:2 capital T then capital R and small r, 1:1:1 capital T small r, here it is 2:1, 2 capital T small t capital R, 2:2:4 T capital R and small r. Here it is 2:1, again 2 capital T and small r combination. Then here it is 1:1:1 small t and capital R, 1 small t small r, 1:1:1 small t then again small r here. So, when we count this ratio, you will get 1 is to 2 is to 1, 2 is to 4 is to 2, 1 is to 2 is to 1. Again, the genotypic F to genotypic ratio. So, in this way, we can justify the statement that a dihybrid cross is equivalent to the product of two monohybrid cross. Now, here the topic incomplete dominance. Here we will get a modified Mendelian ratio. We are slightly moving from the or deviating from the typical Mendelian inheritance. Incomplete dominance is also known as intermediate dominance or blending inheritance or mosaic dominance, or we can say it as partial dominance. So, all these are the synonyms of incomplete dominance. When a dominant parent is crossed with a recessive parent, the F1 produces an intermediate phenotype between the two parents. For example, we can see this phenomenon in Mirabilis jalapa or 4 o'clock plant, and we can see the same phenomenon in Antirrhinum majus, dog flower. The same we can observe in the feather color of Andalusian fowls. Here I will show you the Mirabilis jalapa plant, commonly known as 4 o'clock plant. Different varieties are available, different colors. This is Antirrhinum majus dog flower. Mirabilis jalapa, it is commonly known as the marvel of Peru or 4 o'clock plant flower. It is commonly grown as an ornamental plant species, available in wide range of varieties, flower colors. Mirabilis, in Latin it means wonderful, and jalapa, it is a common place name in Central as well as North America. So, in this section we have to learn about the flower color in Mirabilis jalapa as a typical example of incomplete dominance. A pure breeding red flowered 4 o'clock plant is crossed with pure breeding white flowered plant. The F1 will neither produce red or white, but it will produce an intermediate phenotype, that is, all the progenies will be pink in phenotype. When we cross these individual pink individuals, F1 progenies, and produce the F2 generation. So, by selfing of the F1 pink progenies to produce the F2 generation, we can see the progenies appear in 1 is to 2 is to 1 ratio regarding its phenotype, red, pink and white. So, here we will never get to the ratio 3 is to 1. And we are not getting the ratio of an F1, we are not getting the ratio of a monohybrid cross. So, this shows the variation from the typical Mendelian inheritance. We will get the phenotypic ratio 1:2:1 rather than 3:1. And the phenotypes, we will get 3 different phenotypes here, red one, pink one and white. One red, then 2 pink and 1 white progenies. The cross I will show you here. Incomplete dominance. Parental plants. Phenotype is red and white. The genotype is capital R and small r here. Now, coming to the gametes, capital R gametes are produced here and it will be small r here. In the F1 generation, capital R and small r alleles come together and it will produce an intermediate phenotype in between red and white. We will never get a red or we will never get white. The phenotype is pink in the F1 hybrids. Then F1 on selfing. To produce the F2 generation, we can write it like this. Gametes capital R and small r gametes. Now, we can show it in the Punnett square. Male gametes, and here we will write the female gametes like this. These two alleles capital R, now capital R and small r, again capital R, small r and small r. This one is red, this will be pink, that is the difference. Here also it is pink, this one white. So, we will get 1 red, 2 pink and 1 white progenies. So, here the ratio is 1:2:1. Here you can see the case. A red variety crossed with white variety. In the F1, we obtained pink plants with pink flowers, and by selfing of this F1 pink progeny, in the F2 generation, we can see the flowers red, then 2 pink and 1 white. That means one red, two pink and one white in the ratio 1:2, 2:1. In the pink progenies, here we can see the R gene, capital R gene for red, that is incompletely dominant over small R gene for white. Both capital R gene and small r gene or alleles, they will contribute almost equally in the production of pink phenotype. Genes for red and white do not mix in the F1 hybrids, as both red and white characters appear in the F2 progenies. Both are there in the red as well as white progenies are appearing in the F2 generation. It shows that the genes red and white do not mix in the F1 hybrids. And moreover, there is no specific gene for the production of pink phenotype, pink flower color. There is no quantitative effect of genes. The genotypic and phenotypic ratio here remains the same. That also you can see here. One capital R progeny you can show here. Two progenies are having capital R and small r gene combination, and one is having small r gene combination. So, it is 1:2, 2:1 again, the genotype also and the phenotype also. That means, both the ratios, genotypic and phenotypic ratio, both will remains the same. Yet another example is the flower color in snapdragon, that is Antirrhinum majus. Here also the flower color is a red flowered plant crossed with white flowered one, produced pink flowered progenies in the F1. Again in the F2, same ratio, one red, two pink and one white plants are produced. It is again a modified Mendelian ratio. This is the plant that produces the pink flower, and the plant is snapdragon or Antirrhinum majus. Red variety, different varieties are available here. You can see red flowered one, pink flowered one, and various shades of reds and white also. This is the typical cross F1 progeny with a capital R and small r allele we have crossed. That means they are pink ones in flower color. In the F2 generation, we obtained one red, two pink, and one white. Now, yet another example is feather color in Andalusian fowl. Here, a white male is crossed with a pure black female. The F1 produced blue feather color or blue feathered progenies. Then by interbreeding, in the F2 generation, there is the production of one white, two blue, and one black feathered fowls. You can see here the black one, and this is the blue one, intermediate F1 progeny. Here you can see the cross, this one black male, black one, when we are crossing with the white one, we will get the blue colored progenies in the F1. Again, same thing. Thus, incomplete dominance is a cross between two organisms with the two different phenotypes and produces an offspring with a third phenotype. That is a blending of the parental characters, parental traits. It is just like that of mixing up of paints. For example, when we are mixing red with white, we will get a pink. So, blending of the parental traits will occur in the F1 progenies, and we will get a new third phenotype. Now, we are going to the next aspect, codominance. In codominance, the recessive and dominant characters, traits, both will appear together in the phenotype of the hybrid organism. For example, red and white, when we are crossing a red progeny with a white one, red and white will appear as spots in the hybrid progeny. There is no blending, no mixing. Thus, in codominance, a cross between organisms with the two different phenotypes that produces offspring with a third phenotype, in which both the parental traits appear together. There is no mixing or blending. This is a typical example of codominance seen in cattle. The hair color, the coat color in cattle, when a red one is crossed with white one, you can see in the progenies, red as well as white color both will appear together with the spots. So, this is a typical example of codominance. Here there is no mixing up of the characters, but both the character will seen together. Now, here is a problem for you people to solve. The color of a fruit for a plant X is determined by two alleles. When two plants with orange fruits are crossed, the following phenotypic ratios are present in the offspring: 25% red fruit, 50% orange fruit, and 25% yellow fruit. What are the genotypes of the parent orange fruited plants? You know, you just see the percentage here, in which ratio it is appearing? Yes, it is appearing in 1:2:1 ratio. Regarding the phenotype red, orange and yellow, it means again it is an example of incomplete dominance. So, I will help you to solve the problem. Here in the question it is asked, what are the genotypes of the parent orange fruited plants? We are crossing two orange fruited plants, and what is its genotype? Male and female parents, both the parents the phenotype is orange, percentage red and 25 is yellow. That means, capital R gene and small r gene is here, here also capital R and small r gene present. R capital R gene is incompletely dominant over small r gene and produce the phenotype, a third phenotype, that is orange. Now, the gametes capital R, small r, capital R and small r here. We can show it in the form of Punnett square. Capital R and capital R together, capital R and small r. Here it is capital R, small r, this one is small r, small r. This will be red, this is orange, this is also orange, this one is yellow. So, we will get one red, two orange, and one yellow. That means, again 25% red fruited one, 50% orange fruit at 1 and again 25% is yellow fruit at 1. So, here is your answer. Now, we are moving to the next aspect, mechanism of sex determination. There are different mechanism of sex determination: genetically controlled, metabolically controlled, hormonally controlled and environmentally controlled mechanisms for sex determination in different organisms. The first one, that is genetically controlled mechanism of sex determination. Here also you can see different methods. Chromosomal mechanism of sex determination, genic balance mechanism of sex determination, male haploidy or haplodiploidy mechanism of sex determination, and single gene effect. We have to learn about the chromosomal mechanism of sex determination here in detail. Types of chromosomes. As you all know that in the body of an organism, for example, here in human beings, there are present 22 pairs of autosomes and one pair of sex chromosomes. So, autosomes and sex chromosomes are present. Autosomes will control the bodily characters of an organism and sex chromosomes will control the sexual characters of an organism. In human beings, out of the 23 pairs of chromosomes, that means 2n is equal to 23 pairs, 46 chromosome, 22 pairs are autosomes and one pair is sex chromosome. We can categorize the different autosome pairs into different groups like this. First three pairs, 1, 2 and 3 pairs autosomes, that will form the A group. Then the next two pair, that is 4th and 5th pair will form the B group. Then 6 to 12 pairs of chromosomes, 6th pair to 12th pairs, we will include them into C group. 13 to 15, 13, 14 and 15, 3 pairs, that is coming under the group D. Sixteen, seventeen and eighteen, again 3 pairs, E group. 19 and 20, 2 pairs, F group. 21 and 22, 2 pairs, G group. So, we can divide it into different groups based on its different characters like length of the arms, centromere position, etcetera, from A to G groups. And the sex chromosomes are XX in the case of a female and XY in the case of male individuals. So, there are two different types of sex chromosomes. One is X and the other is Y chromosome. Here you can see the karyotype of a human being. The autosomes as well as the sex chromosomes that are categorized or grouped into different groups. The three pairs, A group, fourth and fifth pair, B group, sixth to 12th pair. Here you can see C group, 13 to 15, D group, 16 to 18, E group, 19 and 20, again F group, 21 and 22, G group. Here you can see the X chromosome seen in the female individuals, and in the male there present a one X chromosome and one Y chromosome. Now, the first mechanism of chromosomal sex determination, that is XX and XY mechanism of sex determination. Here the female is represented as XX, that means female possesses 2X chromosomes, and male is represented as XY, 1X chromosome and 1Y chromosome. The same phenomenon you can see in the case of humans as well as in Drosophila and Melandrium album in plants. When you are observing the male individual here with the X and Y chromosomes, it produces two types of gamete, one gamete with autosome and X chromosome, and the other gamete with autosome and Y chromosome. That means males are producing two different types of gametes, hence it is heterogametic. This particular phenomenon, that is the production of two different types of gametes by the male individual, it is called a heterogamy, male heterogamy or male digamety. Digamety, two different types of gametes are produced. Female is homogametic. Here you can see it possesses only one type of chromosome, that is X chromosome only, XX type. So it produces two gametes, but both of the gametes are of same type with autosome and 1X chromosome only. So, here you can see the situation, female and with the X and XX chromosomes, and a male individual with the X and Y chromosome. So, female produces same type of gamete, autosome and X chromosome only, and the male produces two different types of gametes, autosome with the X chromosome and autosome with the Y chromosome. Now, I will give you the one question to you. The same mechanism of a sex determination you can see in the case of Drosophila also. Work out the same mechanism and represent the cross symbolically using the Punnett square and explain. Thank you for your attention.